I want to talk about something incredibly crucial: how aquaculture prevents disease in fish while also producing healthy seafood. Picture this: a well-maintained aquaculture system with healthy, thriving fish. They're swimming, eating, and going about their normal day. But behind the scenes, there are people designing management plans and working together to ensure that the fish are healthy and safe from disease-causing pathogens. The overall approach can be thought of as having three levels of defense against disease. This first level, called Biosecurity and Disease Response Protocols, is all about preventing pathogens from entering the aquaculture system in the first place. Think of it as a fortress protecting our tanks and our fish from an invasion. Robust biosecurity measures such as controlled access, proper disinfection protocols, and regular health checks significantly reduce the likelihood of pathogens infiltrating the aquaculture system. And if by chance a disease manages to slip through, quick disease response protocols help contain and eliminate the threat before it spreads any further. Now, imagine boosting the fish's natural immune defenses, empowering them to ward off disease without any outside help. That's exactly what Level 2, Good Husbandry Strategies, aims to achieve. If a pathogen slips past Level 1 defenses, then a strong Level 2 will prevent it from causing disease. There are routine, good husbandry strategies, like maintaining optimal water quality, providing balanced nutrition, and reducing stress levels, all of which can enhance the fish's immune system. Just like a healthy diet and lifestyle improve our own immune systems, these strategies significantly reduce the likelihood of disease taking hold in a fish. There are also proactive good husbandry strategies, like fish vaccination and healthy stock selection, both of which occur early in the production cycle to ensure that the fish immune system is enhanced from the beginning, before any potential pathogen exposure. Despite our best efforts, some pathogens may still find a way past levels 1 and 2 and end up infecting the fish. This is where level 3, effective antimicrobial products, comes in. By using powerful antimicrobial products to combat these harmful and sometimes life-threatening microorganisms. Antimicrobial products include antibiotics that attack specific molecular targets associated with the disease-causing pathogen. There are also other antimicrobials that function differently from antibiotics and are often used to treat external infection. In either case, the antimicrobial products are thoroughly reviewed for product safety and efficacy and are ultimately approved by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. They are carefully formulated to target and kill harmful pathogens that have managed to bypass the first two levels of defense. And it should be emphasized that anytime an antibiotic is used, a licensed veterinarian needs to have reviewed the case and prescribed its use. It is extremely important, and sometimes legally required, that a veterinarian is contacted before, during, and after disease treatment. Biosecurity and disease response protocols form the first line of defense by preventing pathogens from entering and spreading within an aquaculture system. Good husbandry strategies are the second level and improve the overall health and well-being of the fish. They can be routine strategies like maintaining suitable water quality, providing a nutritious diet, and reducing overall stress. Good husbandry strategies can also be proactive in that they occur early or before the production cycle. Effective antimicrobial products provide the final line of defense against those disease-causing pathogens that manage to evade the first two levels. Assistance from a veterinarian is essential for proper disease treatment, and a veterinarian should always be involved in designing levels 1 and 2 of your disease prevention strategy. Each level of defense builds upon the previous one, creating a comprehensive disease prevention and mitigation system for our fish. By implementing these three levels of disease prevention and mitigation, aquaculture fish farmers can ensure the health, well-being, and success of their fish farming operations. And there you have it, the three levels of disease prevention and mitigation in aquaculture fish farming. I recently wrote a paper that discusses the disease prevention and mitigation strategies used by commercial aquaculture in the United States. Check out the link in the description below. Let's keep our fish happy, healthy, and thriving. Thanks for watching.